Let's look at the phases of Venus, both for the Ptolemaic system and also the Copernican system. So check this out, right? In Ptolemy's system, the Earth is at the center, the Sun's just orbiting around, and Venus is orbiting on a circle on a circle, this epicycle and deferenting as it goes around, right? And in his system, he always had it, because Venus is always relatively close to the Sun in the sky, he had it so that Venus orbited exactly the same time around 1 year around, just like the Sun does. So let's see how these phases would work. We can see the actual Earth view of Venus up here. So just like with the Moon, when Venus is between the Earth and the Sun, we see the new Venus, I guess you'd say. Let's see what happens as they orbit. Okay, so we start to see a crescent Venus as Venus orbits in its circle, right? And it gets all the way over to here. We maybe even see, oh, and now check it out. We didn't even quite get to like a quarter Venus. It just stayed a crescent. And now as Venus is orbiting around, the crescent is getting a little smaller again, even though Venus is getting bigger in our sky. So let's see what happens here, right? And then when Venus is the biggest, it's a crescent again. Venus is still between the Earth and the Sun, right? So for the moon, when we get a full moon is only when Venus is on the opposite side of the Earth as the Sun. But in Ptolemy's model, Venus could never be on the opposite side of the Earth as the Sun, right? Venus is always fixed between the Earth and the Sun, right? And it always has to be that way in Ptolemy's system. So Venus will only ever show crescent phases. It'll never be gibbous, and it will never be full. Well, let's check this out. Let's check this out. In the Copernican system, here's how it looks different. We have the Sun, of course, at the center. Venus orbits the Sun, and Earth orbits as well. Now let's see how this would be different. Still, Venus could never be on the other side of the Earth, right? So you'd say, well, could we ever see a gibbous phase or a full Venus? Well, let's see, right? Let's see what would happen. All right, we see the big crescent again. And now check it out. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Venus is starting to get a little bit gibbous, right? Venus could be on the opposite side of the Sun as the Earth. And that could allow it to have a gibbous and possibly even a full phase. There it goes, gibbous and full. So unlike the moon, whereas the moon was on the opposite side of the Earth, Venus is on the opposite side of the Sun, but that allows it to have this full phase. So this allowed astronomers to say, hey, look, if we ever see Venus through a telescope, we could see if it has a full phase or not, or even a gibbous phase. And if there is a gibbous phase, we know that Copernicus must be right instead of Ptolemy. And this is a big deal, right? This is proof that the Earth is moving, which is craziness. And of course, as we saw in the video, Galileo was able to get this proof. And today we can still take pictures of Venus and see that it shows a gibbous phase, conclusive proof that the Earth must be moving. Very cool. There's also lots of other modern evidence that the Earth is moving, by the way. But for the time, this was an incredible discovery that could be made just with a telescope.